The following program contains adult language, poor taste in jokes, racial slurs, political slurs, slants, and all sorts of things that if you are sensitive and have a delicate constitution, you should probably go watch Teletubbies. You were warned.
Hey kids, welcome back to Roto Talk.
Hey kids, we're back, and thanks to Uncle Joe at ZipKits, we can continue on our journey of building our A-Box. So, what we're going to do here, you can see we've got this edge, all right, all the way down to here, all the way around, okay? What we're going to do is we're going to plane this down. You don't have to plane it. I use this plane, and I wish to hell I knew the brand, because I bought this and I love it. I'm sure I got it off Amazon. Hopefully I didn't pick it up just randomly somewhere, because I'll never find it again. I'll look for it, because I bought a couple other ones. I just didn't like them. They were either too small or too big. It was, you know, the Three Little Bears thing, Goldilocks. But this one I use constantly. It's never even dulled, and I use this on tons of boats. So what we're going to do to cut down on our sanding time, we're going to simply plane it down. That's all we're going to do. Maybe it is a little dull. Not too bad, though. And what you want to do when you're planing, try to go from the open edge down. Because if you go this way, a lot of times you will split this little edge right here. And it's a bad day to zoo when that happens. So, nothing horrible. I mean, you can fix it with some putty or whatever. We're going to be using putty. Try to go from that end down. And usually what I'll do is I'll usually sand this by hand, the nose, because I like to shape the nose just right. But just to get some of this down, so I'm not sanding so long. If you don't have a plane and don't want to fool around with it, don't. Sand it. That's fine. Now, but you want to make it flush with your chine. Okay? Use a block and sandpaper. Use 80 grit. Use 40 grit. Use whatever you want. Just don't go into the chine. I use, and if you're really good, you can use an orbital for this, because you just need to make it level. And a lot of boat builder guys just cringe when I said that, but I'm a wizard with a freaking orbital, let me tell you, and that's probably how I'll do a lot of this. Then after we get these edges nice and level and flat, then we're going to make sure all of our bulkheads are also flat. And you can feel, like in this case right here, see if I can find a pick. Okay, see that? That's a no good. That one's not too bad. Perfect. That's different. All right, so the reason that is no good, when we go to put our sheets down, our sheets are in two pieces. Let me grab them real quick. These are not our oil streaked. These are the new ones Uncle Joe sent us. Okay. These are going to go like this, right? Okay. So when we glue these down, if you've got a gap here, or an angle going up and hitting this, you're not going to get good glue surface. You're going to glue here, and you're going to glue here, and you're going to miss most of this. So we want to make sure these engine rails are nice and flush. Make sure the bulkheads are nice and flush. Just make sure there's no competing joints. That's what I call it, competing joints. Boxing, okay? And a dead bug on my boat, okay? And make sure that our rail guard's good and everything. So, however you want to do it, you want to use blocking sandpaper, go ahead. You want to take a plane, knock it down first, go ahead. Orbital, if you're good, be very careful. If you're going to use an orbital, do not use 40 grit, because you'll eat right through everything. There's a process to everything, right? And then a lot of times guys will take long 2x4, or if you get the aluminum automotive body sanding bar and go this way, and that way you're covering this whole area and making it nice and flush. Okay, I've done a multitude, myriad of ways. It's just how the flavor hits me for that day. I did refinish my this bench, and I did it too well. Now, nothing sticks to it, because I took this board, painted the old bench, and I actually laminated this big, thick, this is a half inch or three-quarter inch ply, but first I clear coated it with automotive clear so it wouldn't stain and get all gross, but it's slicker than hell, so I'll have to put a towel down or something. But anyway, so I'm not going to video me sanding this, because if y'all got that much time on your hands, you'd go find a girl, go to a bar, do something. So I'm going to do that real quick, and then we will be right back. Bye. All right, so I just got done sanding this. You should have most of your laser marks down. That's finally good. Yeah, everything's nice and fairly level. I don't feel any major obtrusions there. All right. But I did forget a vital piece. Transom doubler. Okay. So this goes on. Should go on pretty much after the sides. What we have to do is you'll have to sand these edges down, because the sides are going to extend a little bit. And you'll notice it is tapered a little bit. You got a little bit of a V here. Put the T towards the boat. Should be fine. There you go. So I'm going to use wood glue for that. Clamp that on there for a few minutes. And then we're going to move on to putting the top on. Be right back. All right, so got this gluing, our transom doubler. Just use wood glue. Stand there pretty good. Clean these off a little bit. Okay, give that a couple minutes to cure up. The next thing we want to do before we put anything on, take some 80 grit or 60 grit sandpaper, and you want to put like a little bit of a chamfer on the keel right here. This keelway right here, just a little bit of an edge, not much. You don't want to misshape it. Don't get carried away. Doesn't have to be exotic. Okay. Get rid of that. This is going to be pretty much flat, so you don't have to worry about that too much. If you can't get in there, use normal sandpaper. You don't have to use a block. We're just putting a little bit of a biting surface on there. Okay. That's it. Feels pretty good. That, like I said, doesn't have to be perfect. You just want a mating surface there. Alright, we're going to let that cure up on the back. And we're going to put the top on. Ah, bottom. Alright, we are back. So, the back is cured up. We've sanded it to make sure it's totally flush with everything. Actually, I feel a little bit of a lump right there. Okay, so what you want to do, this is important, to get a good contact surface around, take your thumb, got two of them, right, or a finger, and feel along the edge where your side of the boat and the bottom chine, lower chine, meet. And make sure you don't feel any lumps or humps, because if you get one of those jobbies in there, your glue surface is going to suck. You're going to have to putty it. You're going to have to seal it better. It's not worth it. Might as well make sure it's good now. Okay. I don't hate it. Looks pretty good. All right. So now what we're going to do, grab our bottoms. Now, in the directions, I think Joe has it. I think he spells out how to do this. I do this a little bit differently. How you do it's how you do it. You know, those directions are made for people that need them. They haven't done it before or whatever. So what you want to do, this cut is where I'm having a brain fart. Skeg, your bottom skeg is going to go. Remember, let's see, it should be up here somewhere. This guy. Okay. And that's going to fit through there like that. That's going to be directly under the engine. Now, what's critical is not necessarily where the skeg is, because it's only going to vary a couple mil here or there. What's critical is making sure you have enough aft and enough forward of material for when you bend this piggy. And you want to measure halfway across the stern and mark it with a pencil. And then it's pretty obvious how to get halfway up the center keel here, because it's laminated, so right in the center. And you're going to mark this. That way you don't go cockeyed crooked here, cockeyed Sally. And then make sure you've got enough to bend around. I'm just mocking it up. I'm not doing anything yet. I'm going to bring it right up to there. See that? Okay. I have a little bit of an overhang in the back, which is what I want. Give it a little bit more, just for grins. Yeah, that's going to work good. So I'm going to go ahead and measure the back and mark it. Where's my tape? There it is. Slide it over here. All right. So give or take, or you could measure right between here. That's pretty much 5.5, 2.5. Okay. Cool. So then you want to think about how you're going to clamp it. Now this side's really easy to clamp because all we got to do is put weight up here. We're going to use a lot of weight. And all we have to do is clamp down. You can clamp here, 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 and here, and clamp the outside. That's easy. It's the other side that's hard, okay? Because now you're not going to have this surface to clamp onto anymore. That's bad. Okay, so there's tricks for that too. So what I do with this first is after I sand it and I make sure everything's nice and clean, I clean it with alcohol. Not the good stuff, not rum, but where the hell is it? My spritzer spray. Anyway, denatured alcohol, because it evaporates really fast, not going to make the wood warp, and we're going to spray it on our gluing surface. Okay? That's going to get all of our dust out. I might even wipe down the bottom side of this. Then we're going to take 30 weight or 30 minute epoxy. We're going to mix up yay much in the cup. What would that be? I would say for this, I would rather have more than less. I'd say 3 ounces at least, I would say. Is that right? Ounces? Yeah. Grams. Yeah, whatever. Half a cup. Better to throw it away than to run out here and be like, shit, okay? And then some guys will actually epoxy the whole panel and glue it down. Not a bad plan. Just a lot of, you have to seal it anyway. I've never done it that way. I've done it on small boats like that, FEs and, you know, little 26, 30-inch jobs. But what we're going to do is we're going to mix it up, and we're going to just gently glue all of this. This side, it's the only side we're gluing, the only side we're epoxying down. Then what I do, this is the best tool you can make for yourself. Take yourself a cutoff wheel on a Dremel and cut a razor blade just like this, right down there. Give it a flat edge on the back side. And then what we do is we use that to scrape up this keel and get all that excess off. A lot of times they'll tell you to tape half of this side. You know, get this into place, mock it up, put painter's tape down there, and then when you're done, peel off the tape. I don't mess with that. I just clean it right off. Because getting painter's tape to stick to wood's, bare wood's a pain in the butt anyway. Here's another trick. This is just a little shop trick for you guys that live in the frozen north like me. If you have a parts washer, which I do, because I build a lot of engines and things like that, and I use... I use a detergent, a water soluble detergent. I don't use kerosene anymore or anything like that. I put my epoxy in here to keep warm, because I bought an aquarium heater, a tropical fish aquarium heater that heats this up to about 97 degrees and keeps it 97 degrees for ever. You can see right here, 94 degrees, whatever. You get the gist, okay? This keeps my epoxy nice and fluid. Not too hot, not too cold. And then, yeah, look at that. We're gonna take our 30 weight, and and we're going to epoxy this stuff up. Rock and roll. So, again, pretty easy stuff. I'm just going to brush it on this one side. I'm going to go ahead and cut one of these razors so I can show you that trick. And that's about it. So, I'm not going to do that on video because it's a pain in the ass. You're just going to be sitting there doing nothing. So, do all this. I'm going to clamp it. And then I'll explain the clamping process after I do it. And I'm going to put weights on it. And then we're going to wait a good 3 hours. I'd like to get it done tonight. So I'm going to wait about 3 hours. Then before bed, I'll laminate the other side. And then in the morning, we can cut this puppy off and get on with our build. Be right back. All right, kids. Welcome back to the mess. Here we are. This side is clamped down perfectly. At least I think. Yep. Looks good. All right. So what we ended up using, 2 bar clamps in the back, okay, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 35, 40. 40 pounds of weights that I clamped along the keel edge, and that razor blade that I cut, okay, when this glue is dry, it's going to scrape right along here and get that off perfect. It's going to look awesome. And then we got some tight clamps down here, a little bit of, if you've got some glue leak, you're gonna have some drips. Guys that say they don't have drips are lying. I gotta put another clamp right there. See that? Okay. So, let's see. We have something that's like a death grip. Gotta be careful. You don't wanna mess up your chine. Let's see. There we go. You wanna check this edge. I might put another one right there. So, put something strong, like steel bar or pieces of wood, along your clamps, and that gave me a nice solid surface there. So I think we are golden. All right. One thing I did forget to mention, sand off your laser edge on these side pieces, right alongside. Hang on. This edge right here, sand that off and give yourself a little bit of a chamfer right there to go along the keel at the top. So halfway, past the halfway point, right past where the skeg goes in, this notch, put a little bit of a chamfer on there so we can mate up with that keel chamfer and you'll have a nice fit. So we're gonna let this cook. It's a little cool out here. It's not cold, but it's not great. I'm gonna let this cook till probably 8 or 9 tonight. It's 5 o'clock now. And that should be good enough to pull everything off. The next side's a little trickier because you can't clamp it like this, right? You have to use more weight. So we'll have to use weights all the way down. And as long as you're careful with it and you don't get too much twisting, these things are stronger than you think. I've had a Thunderboat. You should see the weights I put on there. It's like, looks like a Gold's Gym up there. It's pretty cool. So, I'm going to rinse and repeat, do the other side, and then tomorrow we're going to cut her loose and flip her over. It's going to be awesome. Keep dry side up, kids. Bye.